And the other gentleman, one of the two leaders of the group called Bourgeois Tang. So I'll let him introduce the band that is with him tonight. Reunion recording artist, Mr. Brent Bourgeois.
Thank you very much. Oh. It's really nice to be at a place that I've heard about for a long time. There's a line in this first song that I'm going to do. It says, okay, well, I'm not at the place where I thought I should be. I could talk about it or fret about it, but maybe it's exactly the place I need to be right now. And nothing could apply more to this situation right now. I never thought I would be here. I had a band called Bourgeois Tang in the mid-80s, and I remember at one point we were reviewed by Cornerstone magazine. They thought we were a Christian band, or at least they thought we might be a Christian band. We kind of laughed about that because we weren't. And heard about this place and said, you know, that's not one place I'll ever be. And, but God has his own sense of humor and his own timing. Where would we all be without God's sense of humor? And I brought along a couple of rookies here. They're kind of nervous, but this is a band called PFR. And nice backup band. This is called A Little More Like Jesus.
What's the point of putting on your smile?
play a song now that I asked them to learn about 2 days ago.
And they didn't.
They're probably the kind of guys that didn't do their homework either, but that's okay. Me too. That makes this kind of puts an edge on things when you don't, when you know that they don't know it. This is, and the thing is, this song is called All Is Well, and it's really just kind of one of these songs, you know, that it's no problem. Anyway, here goes. Songs here.
see that.
Let me figure this out. Okay. Your will, not my own today. That's the thought for today, friend of mine. Why is that so hard to do? I write about things that I don't do very well. I should assume most of you out there are Christians. But maybe some of you aren't, and that's great. That's what we're here for. We're not here to talk a lot to ourselves. Sometimes I think we're guilty of all just kind of a little tight circle, and we talk to ourselves about ourselves and about what we're doing. How's our faith? And mine's fine, thanks. How's yours? But I think what we're really here for is the people that don't have this thing yet. Because I was one of those people. I'm one of God's reclamation projects. I bet there's a lot of you here. I've played quite a few churches where I think a lot of those people were born in the church, they live in the church, and they're going to die in the church. I have a little trouble relating to those people because that wasn't my story. My story was one where I was given a gift from God of music when I was very young. I didn't do anything to earn it, and I didn't do anything to make it any better. And I spent the better part of 20 years trying to throw it away, doing everything I could to abuse it and not honor it. Through drug and alcohol abuse and general slovenliness. Through the grace of God, I watched a very good friend of mine go through exactly what I was going through. And his name is Charlie Peacock. He and I were very good friends before. and we're still very good friends now, and we did a lot of the same bad things together. And then we watched Charlie, me and my friends and our friends watched Charlie just go away one day. He wasn't hanging around anymore, and we found out he got sober, and then we found out he got saved, and we felt very sorry for him. We did. We thought his life was, he was going to be resigned to a life of terminal boredom. And that was amazing. I couldn't see, where was the fun in all of this, you know? I had a hard time with that. And I worked with Charlie subsequently after that, and watched his life in action. He never tried to beat me over the head with the Bible, and never tried to influence me in any other way than the way he acted. His life was one of attraction and not promotion, and he had a very attractive model of Christianity, and it really won me over. I did a lot of really bad things in front of him after he got sober and after he got saved, and the grace that he showed me modeled Christianity in a way that made a deep impression upon me and really changed my life. And it took me another year and a half or so after him, but sort of came in the door that he had opened. And then I followed him to Nashville a couple of years later, and he opened another door for me, and now I'm doing this. This is a whole nother story. I've been a Christian for about 8 years, but I never thought I would be a public one. I always was like, I'm a Christian. I don't talk about it. Don't ask me about it. It's none of your business. It's a great Christian, great model of Christianity. I was. You know, we all do this in our own time, and hopefully I've got the message now. I am supposed to give it back. And I'd like to send this next song out to anybody here who was dragged here by one of your Christian friends. And is sitting here going, what am I doing here? What am I doing? I was one of you. I've been to these shows, and I've been these concerts, and you are in the right place if you are here. And we have a lot of fun too. Isn't that right? I finally got that one too. This is called Let His Love Into Your Heart. Just to believe. faith and fear. Divine, true love is crystal clear. I pray you will find the truth in your heart and your brain. Only one can be lonely. I know it's not easy to trust, to believe in someone you can see. But tonight, take the first step to this is Joel Hanson. Maybe you know him, maybe you've heard of him. In softball, if you don't think you have a good enough team, you bring in a couple of ringers, you know, to fill out the team. And that's what I've done. And I'm not proud. But this is a song from my aforementioned past. I see some older people in the crowd. You're going to remember this song. Mom, Dad. It's got quite a bit of MTV airplay at one point. We toured the world behind this song, did the Tonight Show and American Bandstand and all those things. And I think I only bring that up because at the end of the day, it was one more sign that material things were just not going to fill my heart and my soul. And one of the reasons is you can hear what was going on in my mind in this song and the next song. And there's a lot of struggle going on for control of my soul. This is called I Don't Mind At All. The time for talking's over now. I guess it's time to let you go. But I don't know why. Don't mind at all. It's getting so you never know when things are better left alone. Hey, but I don't know why.
I don't know. No, I don't.
PFR. This is Patrick Andrew. This will conclude the confusion medley. This is called I Can't Feel the Pain. Mark Nash on the drums. I'm gonna get a little louder now, is that all right? It's supposed to be a coffee house and all that. This is called Perfect Harmony.
Oh,
the song just came out on the radio. This is called, this is from the Book of Job, and it's called Blessed Be the Name of the Lord. Thank you very much for listening.
PFR, thank you very much. Ryan Rittler on sound. We've got to do another gig now.